So you want to get out of this crazy city, but struggle with trip planning, overwhelming research, keeping track of details, and creating a cohesive itinerary? Or are you simply looking for a quick and efficient way to save time when planning your next adventure? Stop dreading trip planning. In this video, we'll travel smarter, not harder, by unleashing the full power of Google My Maps to plan your next epic road trip. Buckle up. In this video, we'll break everything down according to research and planning, getting started, creating and organizing your location pins, accessing those pins on mobile devices, and downloading your map for offline use. Regarding road trips or trips in general, the real key to minimizing headaches is through research and planning. Things can always go south and sideways, but the impact is felt less when you've planned as much as possible. Please avoid planning at the last minute, especially your itinerary and route. Honestly, for us, planning and researching the destination and route happens several months before our departure date, and packing happens a few weeks before our departure date. It also helps to know what type of traveler you are: luxury, budget, couple, family, adventure, or foodie. Do you prefer nature, small towns, wine, beer, history, or unique experiences? Create a physical or digital list and write down all your points of interest as you discover them. You can also enter your points of interest directly into Google My Maps, which I'll show you shortly. We typically read several blog posts on a destination, looking for things to do, places to see, what to eat, etc. Since we love day and road trips, we will research them from our departing destination and make note of any hidden gems, parks, roadside attractions, hikes, waterfalls, etc. We will also search YouTube for videos about the destination as well as listen to podcasts. We'll also research tourism boards, read books, and ask questions in relevant Facebook groups where we're a part of. We also get inspired by movies, documentaries, and even TV shows. We'll typically add new items to our list as we discover them in the months before the departure date. Okay, once you've developed a list of things you want to do, see, and eat, jump on the computer and open a window for Google Maps. It's important to note that we'll be creating the map on the computer, but when it's done, it will be synced with Google My Maps on your mobile device. All right, on the laptop, open up Google Maps and navigate to the menu, and on the left, click Save. From the headings, you want to click Maps. Located at the bottom, you'll see Create Map. Go ahead and click that. This will open up a new tab, and when you get this pop-up, just click Create. Okay, so in the top right where it says Untitled, you want to go ahead and give this map a name. You want to include the destination's name in the title. It can be as simple as Rome or Our Awesome Rochester Road Trip. You can add a description if you like, but it's unnecessary. Once you're done, click Save. Don't worry about naming this untitled layer. We'll give it a name shortly. Next, you want to find that list you created with all your points of interest and start adding it to your map. I always start with my arrival and departure locations, whether it's an airport, bus, train station, or dock if I'm arriving by ship. I also add my accommodations location, whether that's a hotel or Airbnb, and maybe a hospital, so I know where that is just in case. When I'm road tripping locally, I will start by adding my accommodation. In the search bar, type the first place on your list. Because it's Google Maps, it will automatically start populating all the places with the name of your first place. Choose the correct one. The card that pops up may have useful information, such as the address, website, phone number, etc. You also have the option to view in Google Maps. Clicking this opens a new tab to access all the usual important Google Map information, such as pictures, entrance fees, reviews, popular times, etc. At the bottom of the card, you want to click plus, add to map. You'll notice that your place has been added to the untitled layer. Now you can go ahead and add the rest of the places from your list. Hey my friends, if you feel you're getting value from this video, consider subscribing or even liking it. It really goes a long way towards supporting what we do over here at Rudderless Media. Okay, once you have entered all your pins, you want to zoom out and look at your map. What we're looking for are pins that are somewhat close together so that we can divide the pins based on how many days we have at the destination. If we're road tripping, you can separate the pins based on places en route, at the destination, and on the way home. This is where naming the untitled layer comes in handy, as I mentioned earlier. As you can see, in this example, we are planning a weekend getaway road trip from Toronto to Rochester. The first pin is Niagara Falls. So what we want to do is head over to the top of the box and click Add Layer. Since Niagara Falls would be the first stop, you want to move that to the top. So to do this, hover the mouse over the word untitled layer till the mouse turns into a hand, then click hold and drag the untitled layer so that it's above the current layer, then let go. Truthfully, this process is not always the most responsive, so you may need to try it again. Next, we want to give this untitled layer a name, something like Day 1 or Friday if it's a weekend getaway. Simply click on the word untitled layer and in the edit box, type the name you want to give it, then click save. Next, you want to add as many layers as you need based on the duration of your trip and name each layer according to your needs. Next, click, hold, and drag each pin within the layer to the places where it makes sense according to the logistics of the trip. Here are some things to consider when organizing your pins. When thinking about logistics, locations that are close together can be grouped together. You want to consider the location's hours of operation. What time do they open and close? And what days are they open and what days are they closed? You can organize the pins within each layer based on when you are visiting. For example, a breakfast or brunch location can be at the top of the layer, and the lunch and dinner options can be in the middle or towards the end, respectively. Remember, under the description for each pin, you can add notes such as entrance fees, hours of operation, and specific dishes or drinks you may want to try, personal notes, etc. You can also add pictures too. Change the color of your pins. As a visual person, I like to give all the pins under a specific layer, like Day 1, their own color, so that way they stand out on the map when compared to the other pins in a different layer, or Day 2 in this case. To change the color, hover over the pin and click on the triangle on the right. From the pop-up box, select the color you want. From here, you can also change your pin's icon. This is unnecessary, but it does add to the excitement of planning the trip. Pro tip, you can determine the time it will take to move between each pin or the overall time for all the pins under one layer. Here's how you do that. Double click on the pin you want directions to. Then at the bottom of the card, click on the map icon. This will open up a new untitled layer. In this layer, at the top, you can choose between driving, cycling, or walking as your mode of transportation. From your map, you can select the starting pin. Google My Map will create your route. In the same layer, if you click the three dots and then click step-by-step directions, a new window will appear with the directions, distance, and time frame. You can add more locations by clicking add destination. Your route, distance, and time frame will be updated as you add more locations. I find this tip especially helpful when organizing your locations, as the distance between two locations always looks closer than they actually are. Now that you've added all your pins for the locations you want to visit, you've organized them based on distance and operation hours. You've arrived at your destination and you're ready to access your Google My Maps from your phone, because obviously you weren't planning on walking around with your computer, right? If you're heading outside of your country or into an area where there is a possibility for sketchy internet, stick around, as in the next part, we'll talk about offline maps, which downloading your map for offline use is what you'd want to do before you leave. But for now, to access your maps from your phone, open up Google Maps. It's important that you are logged into the same account that you used when you created the map on the desktop. You want to tap Saved, then tap Maps. From here, you can see all the maps you've ever created. If you tap on View Map Legend, you can see all your pin locations color-coded and divided in the sections that you created. From here, you can tap the share icon, which will bring up a variety of sharing options: AirDrop, Messenger, email, Facebook Messenger, etc. Lastly, if you tap on one of your pin locations, you will now have all the usual Google Map options. Tap on directions and you will see all your usual transit options: car, transit, walking, cycling, etc., based on your current location. As you can see, I'm actually in Toronto, but if I was actually in Rochester, then you can see how useful this is. You can navigate your way to the next location. If you take local transit, then that information is at your fingertips. And if you want to walk, you can pull up the step-by-step directions. It's a game changer. Now, of course, this is great if you're in your own country, but what if you're heading overseas? Or in this case, heading across the border from Toronto, Canada to Rochester, USA. If you're not planning on purchasing a data plan or eSIM, then you can always download your map. Okay, you're ready to hit the road or catch your flight. The next thing you want to do is make your map available for offline use. Now, if you're using your map locally or on a weekend getaway a few hours from your home, your data and access to the internet should be okay. However, if you're road tripping across the border, as in our example, Toronto to Rochester, which involves Canada and the US, you want to make your map available for offline use to save money on data roaming charges. Sure, you can always buy an eSIM to have data in other countries and avoid super high data roaming charges, which we'll talk about in a future video. But there may be times when you are somewhere remote. Sometimes leaving the bigger cities may cause you to have inconsistent or no internet signal. A great example is our road trip from Thunder Bay to Winnipeg. We were way up north where the internet was sketchy at best, and sometimes parts of the map either didn't download or took a long time to download. So to be safe, best practice is to download the sections of the map you need for offline use, as your phone's GPS doesn't require internet. It doesn't take long. Here's how you do it. From your phone, click on your profile picture. Click on Offline Maps. Here you'll find all the maps you've ever downloaded. Click on Select Your Own Map. Move the map so that the area includes all the locations or pins at your destination. Please note the download file size, as the map will take up space on your device. Then click Download. Once downloaded, your map should work with or without the internet. All right, we spent a lot of time creating a map for one of my favorite cities, Rochester. So, if you're planning on visiting or you've never been and want to learn more, check out our video in the top right. And I'll see you over there. Cheers.